Orbital ATK's medium-class Antares rocket sits patiently on the launch pad in Wallops Island, Virginia, Monday. Named OA-5, its main mission is to bring more than 5,000 pounds of cargo to the International Space Station. But it was just a couple of years ago, October 2014, when a similar Antares rocket with similar cargo exploded on liftoff. OA-5 was supposed to take off Sunday night, but a ground support issue delayed it till Monday night. We spoke with Orbital ATK representatives in Wallops Island over FaceTime, and they are expecting a perfect launch.
We're very confident, otherwise we wouldn't be out on the launch pad. We've done everything that we know how to do to make sure this is 100% successful. We expect success. We're confident, but of course, I'd be lying if you didn't say, you weren't a little bit nervous before every launch.
Once in space, OA-5 will drop off cargo at the International Space Station. It will then be filled with waste and then sent off for secondary payload missions, which include various science experiments and the release of Spire CubeSats to help better forecast hurricanes. Back here in Baltimore, virtually everyone in the Channel 11 viewing area should be able to get a good look at the rocket streaking across the sky. This map shows the closer you get to the eastern shore, the better the chance to see it.
We'll be ready to go. We'll initiate the countdown, which all leads to a 7:40 p.m. launch, which, by the way, should be visible up in Baltimore.
Yeah, and the good news is also they have some pretty good weather at Wallops Island tonight, so that shouldn't hamper the efforts of getting this rocket off the ground. NASA will also be broadcasting this live on their webpage. We have a link to that as well as the map we showed you in that story there and everything you need to know about this launch on our website, WBALTV.com, and our mobile app. We're live at the Maryland Science Center tonight. I'm Lowell Melser, WBAL TV 11 News.